Obasanjo or under good Lord Jonathan, who? None of them is a sign of good politicking if you can cover the mess of your leadership. But the Bible, it tells us that Noah, who was the survivor of the flood, he got drunk and exposed his nakedness. The Bible told us that a hero like Abraham, a friend of God, he lied, doubted God, and he slept with a maid. The book who is the focus of the untold truth tell us that Lot, a hero from the story of Sodom and Gomorrah, he got drunk, had an incestuous relationship. He slept with his own daughters and gave birth. Miriam, the beautiful singer and a prophetess of Israel, she had a racial and a jealousy problem and was struck by leprosy. Jacob, who was the founder of Israel, was a thief, a criminal, stole the brother's birthright. Rahab, the woman of faith and the grandmother of Jesus Christ, was a prostitute. David, a man after God's own heart, the Bible says was guilty of adultery and murder. Solomon, the wisest man who ever lived, the Bible says lived the life of a fool. Peter, a leading apostle of Christ, denied his master with curses and with swearing. John, the apostle of love, he called fire to be poured on his enemies, and he was greedy for position. Paul, the apostle to the Gentiles, he was a persecutor of the followers of Christ. He was a murderer. That is how it is. Men write biographies. They patch, they unpatch, they conceal the weaknesses of their heroes and their heroines, but not the Bible. My dear friend, this amazing book, the untold truth about the written truth, is not scared. It has defied its critics. We are told in Isaiah 45, verse 19, that God says, I am the Lord. I speak the truth and I declare what is right. God, he said, when I speak, I am the Lord. I speak what? The truth. And I declare what is right. It will interest you to know, ladies and gentlemen, people have criticized the Bible. In Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 1, the Bible mentioned a city called Hittite, or a people called the Hittites. Until recently, it was only the Bible that have a historical evidence that a group of people lived who were called the Hittites. They lambasted the Bible. They undermined the Bible. In Jonah 1 verse 1 to 2, the Bible says there was a nation or a city called Nineveh. No historical book ever found alluded to say. So they doubted the credibility of the Bible. They undermined it. In Genesis 19 verse 1, the Bible called the place of Sodom and Gomorrah. Everyone criticized the Bible. They undermined it. Until the 19th century, when it was found that there existed, I call it, people were startled by the digger's spade. One morning, an archaeologist was digging, and found a stone. And on that stone was a nation called the Hittites. On that stone was a city called Nineveh. On that stone was a people called Sodom and Gomorrah. The critics of the Bible, they were startled by the digger's spade. Will you say an amen there? We were told that there was nothing. There was no king called Belshazzar. Daniel 5, verse 1. In Isaiah 20 verse 1, there was a king called Sargon. No historical evidence was there that a king or kings ever lived, either called Belshazzar or they were called Sargon. So they destroy the authority of the Bible. It's not inspired. It's not inspired. Only for us to find out. The skeptics also said, Moses, the writings of Moses in Exodus 24, verse 4, Moses said, he wrote, how can an author write and even concluded that he died? So they undermined the Bible. And he wrote in Exodus 40, verse 25, that I saw a wheeled vehicle. There was no wheeled vehicle those days. They undermine the Bible. But today, once again, the critics were wrong. At one time, 39 kings of ancient Israel and Judah who reigned during the divided kingdom, they said they never existed. It was a fabrication. But archaeologists has found the name from Zedekiah to Hezekiah. They found all their names. The Bible, it defied the critics. The untold truth about the written truth. The Bible is a tested book. Theologians have asked rhetorically. The Bible has been chopped. It has been knifed. It has been sifted. It has been scrutinized. It has been vilified with such a venom. They try to destroy this amazing folio with such a thoroughness, with such an eagerness. They try upon every chapter and upon every line and upon every comma. They scrutinize. But a thousand times, the Bible has stood the test of time. The untold truth about the written truth. It says, here are my internal veracities. The internal authority that the Bible is not like any other book. He says, I'm inspired. 2 Timothy 3:16. In 2 Peter 1 verse 3, he says, I came from inspiration of the Holy Spirit. In John 10 verse 35, he says, the scriptures, Jesus said, it cannot be broken. You can break political gymnastics. You can break relational emotion. You can break economic rules. Like a sermon tab, God opposes economics. But the Bible says, and this is Jesus saying, he says the scripture cannot be broken. Amen. Dear friend, tonight, they are told truth about the written truth. I love the prophetic instance of the Bible. It prophesied kingdoms of the world. They came in their succession. The Bible promised that Cyrus, over 150 years before his spare, would take charge and destroy Babylon. In Isaiah 45 verse 1, it was accomplished. That night, Cyrus led a troop that destroyed Babylon under the rule of Belshazzar. When the Bible speaks, it means what it says. And says what it means. Will somebody not say an amen there? Amen. I want you to commit your life to this book. Look, our life is only 85 years, 70 years. But when the Bible speaks 2,000 years and it comes to pass, I must believe it. I must trust it. In Ezekiel 29, verse 14, 15. In Ezekiel 30, verse 12 to 13. It said, Egypt will not be a commanding position among nations again. It was so And it is so. I love the prophetic implications of the Bible. It tells us when Jesus will be born. Micah 5:2. It will fulfill in Matthew 2 verse 1 in Bethlehem. It tells us who will give birth to him. Isaiah 7 verse 14. It was fulfilled in Matthew 1 verse 18. A virgin gave birth to him. He tells us the lineage he will come from. Jeremiah 23 verse 5. It was fulfilled according to Revelation chapter 22 verse 16. He tells us the attempts to murder him by Herod. Jeremiah 31 verse 15. It was fulfilled in Matthew 2 verse 16. The betrayal down to how he would die on the cross, prophecy of the Old Testament and its fulfillment in the New Testament tells me the authenticity of this book. No wonder when Jesus came, this is where the Bible is like no other. My brothers and sisters, see what is happening today in our churches. We go to church and some other story is told. Aside the Bible, Jesus, when he was confronted with temptation, the Bible bore record. He said, it is written. Every instant, it is written. It is written. Matthew 4 verse 4, it is written. Matthew 4 verse 7, it is written. Matthew 4 verse 10, it is written. Why? Even the very existence, the prophetic implication of Jesus' birth stem from the Bible. He lived to fulfill it. That is why the Bible says, sanctify them through or by the truth. For your word is truth. Will you say an amen there? In John 17 verse 17, he says, Lord, you should sanctify the Christian generation. Some of us are looking for spiritual resuscitation. We are looking for spiritual cleansing. We are looking for some spiritual empowerment. The Bible says, sanctify them, wash them, clean them, prepare them, not by speaking in tongues, not by rolling on the ground. Sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth. But see what Satan has done. Today, prayer has overtaken the Bible. The quest for miracles has overtaken the Bible. We go to church. Say, le, 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 le. Zebelelelelelelele, adventures, adventures, kata la 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 la, zendema la 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 la. This noise no wonder we can be sanctified. No wonder temptations overcome us. No wonder the spiritual composition of this book is not seen. I believe the Bible transformed the life of Mary Magdalene. The Bible transformed the life of Levi Matthew. It's not just a book. It's about a person. John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Will you say an amen there? Amen. It is not just a book. It's about a person. Verse 3, nothing was made that was made without him. Verse 14, he came to the world. The world received him not. It's talking about a person. My dear friend, the untold truth about the written truth. But before I begin to wrap up tonight, this book is a book of promise. We go to places. I don't know about your country, In Ghana, church members go to church just to be told, just to be reminded that they have a prophet who is there for prophets. So they pay consultation fee before they see the prophets, just for the prophet to tell them two Bible verses. One woman met me, say, "Pastor, I want to feel that the prophetic message that came from the man of God today will change my life." Quick prophetic word. It says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Do you have a Bible?" She said, "Yes." "Do you need a prophet to read that to you before you believe?" The Bible has over 3,800 prophecies. In fact, promises, I intend to say. Are you scared of demons? Isaiah 41 verse 10. "Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, yea, I will help you, yea, I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness." Will you say an amen there? First Peter chapter 5 verse 7. He said, "Cast all your cares, sickness, cast it on him. Deliverance, cast it on him. Academic pursuit, cast it on him." You don't need a prophet. You just need to believe. Cast all your cares upon him, for he cares. I want to tell you tonight, the Bible is filled with unfathomable truth which are encouraging. Job 2 verse 21. "Fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do great things." Will somebody say an amen there? Isaiah 49 verse 15. "Can a woman forget her nursing child and have no compassion on the son of a womb? Surely they may forget, yet I will not forget you." God says, "I have inscribed you in the palm of my hands." Some of you sleep at night and you run to prayer centers because you don't know the truth about the power, the promises of this book. God says your parents can reject you. Some of you, in the next 2 weeks, you will accept some truth. Your husband will want to leave you. God says, "I inscribe you in my path." I was conducting an evangelistic meeting just some 2 months ago. One 15-year-old girl, she wrote a letter to me. I wish I had brought it. She said, "I'm convicted and convinced that this is the truth. I'm 15 years old. Where I live, they threaten me that I follow the truth, nothing. They will throw me out. Pastor, what do I do?" She can't see me. She must hide in the darkness. The person she wrote the letter to asked my wife to write something and send back to her. And I said, "Young girl, Jenny, pseudonym, Jenny, I've listened to your concern. I have no answer." And I gave her Isaiah 49, verse 16. She said, "Pastor, I want to get baptized. I want to follow truth, but I am scared." I say, "See, God said, I've inscribed you in his own power." When God lifted his hand, he sees you. He said, "You are the apple of his eye." That young girl, she ran away from home. She took the decision. She's baptized. She's a happy Christian. Will you say an amen to God? We are scared. Sometimes you go to sleep in the night because many of us have allowed witches and wizards to slay us. The Bible has a promise for us. Isaiah 49, 26. He says, I will feed them that oppress thee with their own flesh. They shall be drunken with their own blood and with the sweet wine. And all flesh shall know that I am the Lord. I am your Savior. I am your Redeemer. And I am the mighty one of Jacob. Will you say an amen there? Amen. Last time I was preaching and some things were happening to my knee. I went to the room. I said, Satan, you are a coward. You are a coward. I am just a small boy. I'm not preaching my word. If you have power, I recommend you meet my master. His name is J-E-S-U-S. 3 days time, I begin to walk. Will you say an amen there? Amen. That is the power that comes from the word. Some of us are here. Our past lives cannot make us have a future. God invites you. This is the unbold truth about the written truth. He said, come now. Let us reason together. Says Buhari. Says good luck. Says Obasanjo. He said, come now. Let us reason together. Says who? The Lord. Know your sins. People may know you. They give you back name. Know your sins. Be as scarlet. They shall be white as snow. Though they be like crimson, they shall be as wool. Will you say an amen there? I believe it. The untold truth about the written truth. When I finished school, I was in the house for 4 years. This was a text. I went to a church in my village and I knelt down at dawn, 12 midnight, and I read Psalm 37, verse 4 and verse 5. He said, delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desire of your heart. He says, commit your ways to the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. God sent a sponsor. I've gone to school and I've completed. What are you scared of? What future are you looking for? He says, ask and it shall be given. He says, seek and you find. He said, knock and it shall be open. He said, whatever you ask in my name, not in the name of a prophet, not in the name of a pastor, not in the name of a bishop. Ladies and gentlemen, the untold truth about the written truth, irrespective of the power of this book. The Bible is a neglected book. You go to hotels, it's there. You go to motels, it is there. The Bible is crying, read me, read me, read me, read me. I want to ask you right now, either listening to me or here in this auditorium right now, when was the last time you studied the Bible for yourself? When was the last time you read it for yourself? When was the last time it was warm up your heart? I love the Bible. Sin prevents men from reading the Bible, or the Bible prevents men from seeing. Sin that deceives, sin that disappoints, sin that dominates, sin that disgraces, sin that destroys. That is why Jesus said, search the scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life. They are they who testify of me. From the books of the Psalms, from the laws of Moses, even to what we call the prophet. Jesus said, they speak about him. This opening night, I present to you the living word. I present to you the life transforming book. I present to you the neglected book. I present to you the book no one takes cognizance of. I present to you a book that can let you grow spiritually. 1 Peter 2, verse 2. As newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that you may grow thereby. Do you want to grow spiritually? It is not tongues, it is not prayer, it is nothing. As newborn babe, desire, be willing, be desirous, be eager, be anxious that you will drink of the sincere milk of the word, that you may grow thereby. Do you want to overcome sin? How can a young man keep his way pure? Psalm 119, verse 9. By living according to your word.